I like Raymarching. It's an untraditional way of rendering graphics without the use of polygons or triangles, but it's rarely used in mainstream games. There are some indie games like Marble Marcher or Claybook that use it. However, most of the time, Raymarching is relegated to rendering clouds in AAA games, which does look pretty cool, but doesn't utilize the full power of Raymarched rendering. So, I decided to make my own game. As an introduction, I'm a computer science major from Canada, and in my very first summer in university, I made a project that recreated Minecraft's terrain generation. I was doing everything in the CPU since I didn't know how code runs on the GPU. But a year ago, after seeing Sebastian Log's video about Raymarching, and later Inigo Quiles' videos, I decided to learn how shaders work, and how you can utilize them both graphically and computationally. I started my way with 2D shaders, dabbled with some compute shaders with SLIMOS simulations, and finally became confident enough to start on a 3D Raymarched shader. With that out of the way, I started the game by first defining what the main loop of the game is. At the end of the day, no matter how pretty a game looks,
if it's not fun, why bother?
So, here's what I came up with. Since I really enjoyed the wingsuit mechanic in Superfly, I decided to make the game loop an extended version of that, where when you do a near miss, you gain points like Superfly, but you also get a boost that you can later use to speed yourself up. Also, the faster you are when you do a near miss, the more points you get, but if you get hit, you die. Seems simple enough, and with a complex fractal terrain, I think the game can be pretty fun. So, I started by making a new Unity project and used some old Raymarch shader code that I did for a previous school project to make an image effect shader. This allowed me to overlay the Raymarch geometry on top of whatever Unity renders, and with the use of depth buffers, I can essentially render both Raymarch geometry and polygonal geometry at the same time. After that, I started working on making the player controller. I followed this tutorial by Omar Balfaqi on making a wingsuit, but didn't like how the movement was not physics-based. In Superflight, the challenge of the wingsuit mechanic was the fact that you could end up not being able to steer the character if you go too fast. And so, it seemed more intuitive to use physics with that. In the end, I ended up with the logic that was on the tutorial, but with the use of rigid bodies at force and at torque for movement and steering. Finally, I needed some terrain. I knew that I wanted some sort of fractal, but didn't want to just take someone else's code and not understand what's happening. I also knew that the math involved space folding, but wasn't quite sure how that worked. After researching, I found CodeParade's video and his PySpace code. And with it, I realized that the insane math that was involved with some shaders is actually just the folding functions that he made. And so, I was able to create an Apollonian fractal that looked like terrain. And once I added it to the scene with my controller from earlier, I ended up with this.
Thank you.
There is a lot more for this project. First, performance. I need to somehow make this run on any GPU with a good frame rate. I do know that a good place to start, though, is to see how cone marching is done. Second, the controls. I need to work more on the player controller, adding all the features that I have in mind. Third, aesthetics. I need to make a good model for the player character that isn't just a sad-looking cube, and I need to color the terrain with more sophisticated methods. Fourth, VFX. I need to add things like blur or anti-aliasing and other fancy effects. And finally, I need to polish the game, which will take most of the time, probably. That being said, I did end up playing the game a lot. As a matter of fact, there was a day where I felt like I played the game more than I actually coded. So, it's promising to say the least. That's it for this devlog. If you have any suggestions about the game or know a way or two around optimizing Raymarching, please let me know in the comments section. Also, if there's demand for it, I'll make a tutorial on how I'm rendering this scene. But there are a lot of great videos about Raymarching, which I will link down below alongside the other videos and resources from my research. Thank you all for watching, and until next time, bye-bye!